Thank you, Amanda. Hi, everyone. That's all yours. So at Cute Circuit, we designed the future of fashion. As Amanda just said, we started 10 years ago in 2004, and we just celebrated our 10th birthday on February 2014 with our Fashion Week show at New York Fashion Week. And over the years, we started like the company thinking immediately that we wanted to design something that was magical. So we use microelectronics, interactivity, and smart textiles merged together to create really beautiful, wearable experiences that are emotionally enriching, but also really magical and beautiful to look at. So we really wanted to start a company that was about using future technologies, but at the same time making sure that these technologies would actually become something desirable, not just something that works and you don't know what to do with it. And so we're going to go through a number of products that we developed over the year, and maybe you heard about them. And then we're going to have a little surprise in a few minutes. And so this is one of the first garments that we designed, and it's called the hug shirt. And it's a t-shirt that lets you send the sensation of being hugged over distance. So imagine you're here in Munich, and your best friend is in Tokyo, and you want to send them a hug. You put on the hug shirt to give yourself a squeeze, and sensors capture where you touch, for how long, how strong. And all this data is transformed into a hug message. And when your friend in Tokyo receives this message, their shirt is going to get warm and vibrate in the same area that you touched on your shirt. So it's touch telecommunication over distance. And I mean, we had lots of fun doing the user testing for it because lots of people were hugging for a very long time in a dark room. Some of them got married afterwards. But it's even true. But then when we started like showing it in different shows, people say, okay, yeah, it's very cute and fashionable and it's very playful, but at the same time could be used by blind people to communicate with each other or maybe with patients that need motor rehabilitation, because anyway, it's something that is touching you and is activating something through touch. And so we continue working on garments that could telecommunicate. And next one is Ryan's favorite.
About the same time that we were designing the hug shirt, we also designed this, which is called the M dress. And it occurred when I tried to call Francesca on the phone that she never answered my calls. And I said, Francesca, why don't you answer my calls? She said, well, I'd like to, but the phone's always at the bottom of my purse and it takes too long to answer it. And I said, this is an interface problem. We need an easier way to answer the phone. So we designed a dress that is a mobile phone. So when somebody calls you, your dress rings. And in order to answer the call, you raise the wrist, and there's a sensor in the wrist that initiates the call. And there's also a microphone and speaker so that you can maintain the call. And then when you're done, you simply drop your hand, and the gesture closes the connection.
Yes, and I answer my calls much faster now. I can have a record holding on the Guinness Book of Records.
So both of these projects date back, as Amanda mentioned, almost 10 years. So Cute Circuit has been designing wearable technology for over a decade now, which is really exciting. But you can see from the beginning, the concept was very different. The concept was to create fashion that did something spectacular rather than simply find a way of strapping technology onto the body.
And this is one of the dresses that we designed for the Museum of Science and Industry in Chicago. And it's a dress that we spent 6 months embroidering with 24,000 LEDs. They're like micro little LEDs. At a certain point, we were taking so long to embroider this dress, and the exhibition really had to open. So we got one of the adorable curators from the museum come to embroider with us because she really likes embroidering and knitting. And so it just sort of became a collaborative project to get it done really, really fast. And it's been in the museum for 6 years now, so it's on every day. And after we did this dress, everybody started seeing like this new kind of fabric that is a fabric that keeps changing color, so it can adapt to your mood. And this was really one of my dreams. Like when I was a little kid and I would play like with my toys, and I would say, wouldn't it be awesome if these dolls like would change color, like their dresses would change color? Of course, it couldn't happen. So I kept thinking about it in the back of my mind for many, many years. And then finally we managed. And so after we did this garment, oh yeah, there was even a video, I didn't even know. But I can skip because you're gonna see even something more interesting in a few seconds. So, oh, this lovely girl, Katy Perry, decided to wear one of our dresses on the red carpet at the Met Gala. And I think that was sort of like the turning point for wearable technology, like that is like fashion wearable technology. Because before people kept thinking, oh, it's gonna be something really geeky. Maybe it's a dress full of horrible wires with a car battery this size that you have to lug around on a cart. And then finally, Katie decides to wear the dress, go out on the red carpet, and of course, she's not wired, there's no scary things inside it, and she just goes party the whole night, and she's having lots of fun. So
thank you. This is a company called Cute Circuit. They're from France. And I like, you know, things that light up. I love living in the future. I feel like when Blade Runner predicted the future, I'm living in it now, you know?
I love Katie. She's awesome. We were in the car with her, and we were going to the Met Gala. And she's like, so where are you guys from? And he's like, well, I'm Italian, but we live in London. He's American. And she's like, the chiffon is French. And she just goes out there. And she's like, they're French. So everybody now thinks we're French. We're actually not. But the thing that we really liked is that we did something like really experimental, but then we also wanted to bring it to everyday life. So we started to work on a ready-to-wear collection because lots of girls saw Katie's dress and they were like, well, I'd like to wear it, but I don't really go to the Met Gala every day. The dress is a bit too long. I'm just going to step and stumble on it. And so we designed this short version that became one of our bestsellers on our website. And we did it as a mini collection for Selfridges as well in London. And basically, we used one of the last two remaining pleaders that is a darling old gentleman in London. And so he hand-pleaded this silk, and then we added the lighting behind. So we like to merge something that is very traditional and maintaining the skills and the craftsmanship that you find in the fashion industry. But then at the same time, we really enjoyed like adding some sparkle and something that is really futuristic. Oh, that's what I'm wearing. So this one is a garment that is motion activated. So when we started the collection, as someone was saying this morning, it was like, oh, well, sometimes you have to step sideways. So we're like, well, we cannot put on the market a dress with 24,000 LEDs right away, but we can create something that is much lighter to carry around, a little bit more discreet, except for this very large amount of Swarovski crystals, and they can react to your movement. So we brought something that was like in a museum and then on the red carpet to something that you can actually wear every day. So this one reacts to my movement. If I'm perfectly still, doesn't do anything, then if I start to move a little bit, it starts like to react. So it's sort of like one of those bracelets that Amanda was talking about. It's monitoring your movement. But it's monitoring my movement, but then it's doing something really visual and fun about it. And this brings to what's going to happen next. So Ryan is going to tell you about it.
And it's crazy.
Nicole Scherzinger making Twitter fashion history after wearing a crystal-encrusted digital dress which lights up to spell out tweets sent by fans.
It's a dress that they designed specifically for me.
And Brian's tell you more about it.
So this is the Twitter dress that we designed in 2012 for Nicole Scherzinger. She was wearing it to a red carpet event at the launch of the EE mobile network, and she was also the entertainment of the evening. And they wanted a way to have this event sort of happen in a real place, but also globally, so that the fans could send tweets to her dress as she's arriving on the red carpet. Now, I know what you're asking yourselves. What did the fashion police say about this?
I absolutely love this dress, regardless of the fact that you can, it has live tweets on it. It's one of the best dresses I've ever seen her wear. It's cut nice on her, it's not showing too much skin, but it is showing skin in the right places. Her hair and her makeup looks beautiful. It's amazing, like, it, and I think it's a start of a new trend. I am absolutely obsessed with this.
Yeah. We love them. We are not showing you what Joanne said about it.
She didn't hate it, but it was a little too
rude.
Really
funny. She was a little naughty, as usual.
So we took this concept of connected clothing that we had been designing from the very beginning with things like the hug shirt and the M dress, and the Twitter dress, which was connected to the internet via Twitter, and we wrapped that into our latest collection. So now we're going to show you a very brief clip from our latest show at New York Fashion Week, where every dress on the runway was controlled in real time by the models as they walked down using a smartphone. And most of them have the Twitter functionality. So as we show some of these things, if you tweet to Cute Circuit, you will see it appear in a few minutes.
Magically, on someone's dress. And the thing that we wanted to do with this collection is that we wanted to bring the concept of transformable clothing even a further like step ahead. So you can customize it, you can create your own content. So basically, fashion is not anymore like selling 2,000 skirts in many different like shapes and colors, but having one garment or two or three garments in a shape that you really love, that really fits well on you, but then you can create new content and have like 2,000 different skirts that you can keep updating. And sort of basically the fashion industry model shifting from selling lots of units to selling services and content, which I think that's the future of fashion. So we start the video and...
We don't want to start the video or the music?
Oh, we start the music, okay. Maybe. And we'll get... Yeah. We'll get the lovely... Ooh, the lovely DLD interns, ladies and gentlemen.
Elvis is my daddy, Marilyn's my mother, Jesus is my bestest friend. We don't need nobody, cause we got each other, or at least I pretend.
Traditional British honeycomb dress that took us just 2 weeks to embroider. And you see all this pleating is actually handmade because our pleater didn't have time to help us back in February. And then there is this gradient of Swarovski's. And then she has this lovely handbag that is also controlled with your mobile phone. And instead, Caro is wearing our mini skirt. It's the eye mini skirt. And actually, if you've been tweeting at Cute Circuit, your tweet might already be scrolling on there. And then she's wearing our finale dress. So this one is actually being controlled by Ryan, and this is the same system that we use when we do costumes for big stage shows and rock concerts. And so it has a very long-range wireless controller, so we can change all the animations and then just activate them very dynamically. So imagine next time you will have your own content on this skirt. So I think it will pass everything back on to Amanda that's going to start the panel. And thank you so much for listening to us today.